demonstration effort be made to develop technology necessary to eliminate the discharge of pollutants. I'll come back to that. It is a national policy that programs for the control of non-point sources of pollution, that's runoff from the land, be developed and implemented in an expeditious manner to enable the goals of this chapter to be met. In other words, to go along with the 1985 goal of eliminating the discharge of pollutants. Here is a part of the law that lawyers don't even remember. And in some ways, the most dramatic and heartbreaking part of the Clean Water Act. And here's what it says. It is further the policy of Congress that the President, acting through the Secretary of State and such national and international organizations as he determines appropriate, shall ensure that to the fullest extent possible, all foreign countries shall take meaningful action for the prevention, reduction, and elimination of pollution in their waters to at least the same extent as the United States does under its laws. The Secretary of State was supposed to launch an international program to assist other countries to eliminate pollution in their nations. To at least, and then it doesn't even say pollution, it says, test pollution, reduction of pollution to at least the same extent as the United States does under its laws. It's not just about the Clean Water Act. Under its laws means the Safe Drinking Water Act as well. We're supposed to help other nations. Now, why is this important? This is important for a myriad of reasons. One reason is, let's see, I've been speaking for about 12, 15 minutes, let's say 15 minutes. In the 15 minutes I've spoken to you, 60 children in the developing world have died from diseases due to water pollution. 60. And 4 more will die every minute while I'm talking to you. And my stopping talking is not going to stop that. 4 children a minute in the developing world die from diseases due to water pollution. And you want to know how miserable that death is for most of those children? They're dying from diarrhea. What does this mean? Okay, let's go backwards to the research and development part here. Had we fulfilled the purposes of this law, had we created the era of innovation that the Clean Water Act called for, had we done the research and development that the Clean Water Act called for, had we striven to achieve the elimination of the discharge of pollutants, we would be the global center for clean water on this planet. We would have stopped children dying in the developing world. We would have helped remedy the fact that 1.2 billion people on this planet do not have access to sanitary water in the 21st century. Instead, since the Clean Water Act was written, 70 million children have died. In the developing world. This is not just about other countries. Last year, 19.5 million Americans got sick from their drinking water. 19.5 million Americans got sick from their drinking water. Since 2006, in New York State alone, 205 municipalities have had violations of drinking water, bacteria and viruses. What has gone wrong? What has gone wrong? What happened to this extraordinary vision we had? This extraordinary domestic agenda that was supposed to reach out to the rest of the planet. How did we go so horribly wrong? And why is it, and I say this freely in any audience, why is it that it's so easy for my colleagues in the environmental movement to move past the water issue and just to start working on other things? Why is it that we call the Clean Water Act one of the most successful of our environmental laws?